from Electronics and Telecommunication Department, working as a assistant professor. Today we are going to see the working of junction field effect transistor from the chapter number 1. In previous lecture we have started that the chapter number 1, that is introduction, we have seen for the junction field effect transistor. So this is our outline of today's session. So in this session we are going to see working principle of JFET, then schematic symbols of JFET, then difference between JFET and BJT, and advantages of JFET. So for our syllabus, we are going to see N-channel JFET, so working principle of N-type JFET. So structure already we have seen for that the N-type JFET. So in N-type JFET, N substrate is sandwiched between two P-type material. So in this figure, this is the N-type substrate. Over that P-type substrate is there. So for JFET there are three terminals are there: gate, drain and source. So JFET is a voltage controlled device. So output drain current is controlled through this VGS. So in JFET for N-channel, the external voltage applied between gate and source is in a reverse biased, while in a drain and source it is in a forward biased. So let us see the working of JFET. So this figure shows N-channel JFET with normal polarities. Then there are two PN junctions at the side, form two depletion layers. So when there is a negative field applied here, so it is in a reverse biased. So there is a attraction of the electrons for the negative terminal of the battery, and then here the depletion layer is going to be formed. So through the channel there is a two depletion layers are formed. So here in this figure these are the two depletion layers. So when the depletion layer is stretched for the simple PN junction, so when we applied reverse biasing across the PN junction, at that time the charged particles are attracted towards the negative terminal of the battery. So positives are attracted towards the negative terminal of the battery, and electrons which are negatively polarized, they are attracted towards the positive terminal of the battery. So that's why the recombination process will start and it will expand that the depletion layer. So in JFET there are two PN junctions for this set as well as for this set. So due to this, the both the side the depletion layer is shown. So while we are going to see that the working principle of JFET, so different cases we are going to consider here to see the working principle of that JFET. So let us see here the width and hence the resistance of this channel can be controlled by changing the input voltage VGS, because when we increase the VGS in a negative manner, so the resistance of that the width is going to be decreased. So the greater the reverse voltage VGS, the wider will be the depletion layer and narrower will be the conducting channel. The narrower channel means greater resistance, and hence source to drain current decreases. When reverse will happen when VGS decreases. Thus, JFET operates on the principle that width and hence resistance of the conducting channel can be varied by changing the reverse voltage VGS. So in other words, the magnitude of drain current ID can be changed by alternating the VGS. So this VGS means this VGS applied for that the N channel, it is in a reverse bias we have applied. So due to that, the channel width is going to be increased or decreased. So when VGS is the zero, at that time there is a small depletion layer is created and N channel, the width of the N channel is wider. So at that time maximum ID current flow through this channel. So when VGS is zero, ID is the maximum. When we are going to increase this negative VGS, at that time the depletion layer is going to increase and the width of the channel is also reduced. So for the recombination process, there is no charge carrier, so that ID becomes that the minimum value. So when VGS is greater negatively, at that time ID, minimum ID current flow from this the JFET. So let us see the first case where that the here when voltage VDS is applied between drain and source terminals and the voltage on the gate is zero. So the two PN junction at the sidebar establish depletion layers. So the electrons will flow from source to drain through the channel between the depletion layer. So the size of depletion layer determines the width of the channel and hence current conduction through the bar. So in first case, when the VGS is zero, at that time maximum current flow from the device, because the depletion layer is less and that the N channel width is more. Then in a case 2, when a reverse voltage VGS is applied between the gate, the source terminal as shown in figure, the width of depletion layer is increased. So this will reduce the width of conducting channel, thereby increasing the resistance of the N-type bar. So consequently, the current from source to drain is decreased. So this is nothing but the controlling action through the external input voltage, that is VGS. So due to that, the JFET is known as the voltage control device, because VGS is applied at the input of that the JFET, and from the output side we are going to measure the ID current, and this ID current is depending upon that the how much amount of the VGS is applied at the input side. So when we are increasing this VGS, at that time the ID going to be reduced. So that's why the JFET is known as the voltage control device. So if you see the another type of the transistor, then for example BJT. So BJT is the current control device, whereas JFET is the voltage control device. So that is the main difference between the JFET and BJT. So here working of the three stages of N channel JFET is shown. So very first, there is a gate and source is shorted. So at that time there is a depletion layer which is very near to that the P substrate. So large number of amount of N substrate is open to flow that the drain current from this side to this side. So when after that when we are going to control that, we have to apply the negative VGS here, so that due to that the attraction of that the positive charge particles towards the negative terminal of the battery and electrons towards the positive terminal of the battery, the width of this depletion layer is going to increase in second case. So the width available for that the flow of current is going to reduce, and due to that ID current gets decreased. So in a third stage, we have increased this VGS up to that much the depletion layer is touches to each other. So here there is a no any that the channel width is available to flow of current, means in this stage the ID becomes totally is, or approximately we can say it is equal to zero. So this is nothing but the operation of the n channel JFET, where by controlling the input voltage VGS we can control the output current ID. So in first case VGS is zero, ID is maximum. VGS is a little bit increased, ID gets decreased, and VGS is maximum at that time, ID current totally zero. So this is nothing but the controlling operation of that the n channel JFET. So on other hand, when the reverse bias on the gate is decreased, the width of the depletion layer also decreases. So this increases the width of the conducting channel and hence source to drain current. So if you take the p-channel JFET, so it will operate in the same manner as the n-channel JFET, except that the channel current carries will be the holes instead of the electrons, and the polarities of VGS and VDS are reversed. So in university paper, if they ask to write the working principle of JFET, so you can go with p channel or n channel. Only remember that we have to change the polarities of VGS and VDS according to the which channel you have selected for that the explanation. So for the n channel JFET, electrons are responsible to flow of current, and for the p channel the holes are responsible to flow of current through that device. So that's why only one charge carrier is responsible to flow of current from that the transistor. So that's why the JFET is known as the unipolar device, while BJT is known as the bipolar device. These are the schematic symbols of JFET. So for the n channel JFET, the gate arrow inside that the channel, where for the p channel JFET it is the outward. So in very previous also we have seen the symbols for the transistor. So in that also BJT, PNP and NPN transistor, we have seen the schematic symbols. So just like that, for the JFET is also having the schematic symbols, and again the same theory for that the arrowhead, because always the arrowhead indicate that the flow of the conventional current. So it is towards the n channel, so or n material. So for that the n channel, it is the sandwiched between the two p materials, so that's why the arrow indicating inside that the, and for that the p channel JFET, that the n is the outer layer, so that's why it is outward the that device. So let us see the difference between JFET and BJT. So in a JFET there is a only one type of carrier, that is holes in a p type channel and electrons in a n type channel. So for this reason it is also called a unipolar transistor. So however, in an ordinary BJT both electrons and holes play role in conduction, so therefore it is called as a bipolar transistor. So the first difference already we have seen in our previous basic sessions, so that the BJT is the bipolar junction transistor, because both electrons and holes play important role while in the conduction, and therefore the current flow in that the BJT due to the electrons and holes, whether it is NPN or PNP. So both are responsible for the flow of current. But in a JFET, only one, that is holes or electrons, are reason to flow of the current from that the device. So that's why it is known as the unipolar transistor. Then next, as the input circuit of JFET is reverse biased, therefore it has a high input impedance. However, the input circuit of BJT is forward biased and hence has low input impedance. So in a we have the practical examination for our electronics device and circuits. So at that time, there is a, every time external will ask you that why the JFET is unipolar and BJT is the bipolar, and also you have to justify for the JFET having that the high input impedance and BJT having the low input impedance. So at that time you have to answer that the JFET is a, means input circuit of JFET is a reverse biased, so that's why it is having the high input impedance, and for the BJT the input circuit is forward biased, so it is low input impedance. Then the primary functional difference between the JFET and the BJT is that no current enters the gate of JFET. However, in typical BJT, base current might be a few microampere. So in BJT, already we have seen that the collector current, it is nothing but the combination of the emitter and the base current. So IC is equal to IE plus IB. But in the JFET, there is no any gate current is considered while we are expressing that the output drain current. Then the BJT uses the current into its base to control a large current between collector and emitter, whereas a JFET uses voltage on the gate terminal to control the current between the drain and source. So BJT is known as the current control device and JFET is known as the voltage control device. In JFET, there is no junction. Therefore, noise level in JFET is very small. And in BJT, there is two junctions are there. So, noise level is high in a BJT. Let us see the some of the advantages of JFET. So a JFET is a voltage controlled constant current device in which variation in input voltage control the output current. So let us see the advantages one by one. It has a very high input impedance. So why it is having the high input impedance? Because JFET input circuit is in a reverse biased, that's why it has very high input impedance. So this permits high degree of isolation between the input and output circuits. Then next, the operation of a JFET depends upon the bulk material current carries that do not cross the junction. So when the bulk material current carries that do not cross the junction, therefore the inherent noise of tubes and those of transistor are not present in a JFET. So here no any junction, so that's why there is no any noise. But in a BJT, junction is there, so that's why noise is present in a BJT. So a JFET has a negative temperature coefficient of resistance. So this avoids the risk of thermal runaway. But in a transistor, there is a risk of a thermal runaway. So due to that, the BJT transistor gets damaged when it is overheated or due to the outer environment. So a JFET has a very high power gain. So this eliminates the necessity of using driver stages. But in a BJT, there is a number of stages are required for the high power gain. So in a JFET has a smaller size, longer life and high efficiency as compared to the BJT. So in this session we have seen the working principle of JFET. There is a always question on explain the working principle of JFET. So you can go with any the type of the JFET, either p-type or either n-type, and discuss that the all the cases which we have discussed here, and then write the also advantages of the JFET. Thank you.